one can say that the Philadelphia sports fan is not passionate. Philadelphia has five major sports teams: baseball, basketball, hockey, soccer. But the recipient of that passion in the greatest amount is without a doubt the football team, the Philadelphia Eagles. It is the place where America was born. It is a place where the founding fathers showed their passion for freedom, for liberation from a tyrannical government. It is a passion which was kindled long before the year of 1776, and a passion which still continues in 2019. Founded in 1682 and built on Quaker ideals, Philadelphia has long been the city of underdogs, a city with passion, a city with some of the toughest and some of the best sports fans in the world. The ultimate underdog, a club fighter from the tough and crime-filled streets of Kensington, given the opportunity to take on the heavyweight champion of the world. A fight in which nobody gave him a chance, and yet he went the distance. And in a rematch, defeated that champion to go on to become heavyweight champion of the world himself. It is the home of one of the finest collections of art in the world. Yet people come just to run in the footsteps of the ultimate underdog. A testament to what is Philadelphia, the city of underdogs. But the visiting team can be just as passionate. And you can bet that on any given Sunday, there will be people rooting for the other team.
Hoping the Lions can win, but if not, we're still going to have fun in Philly. Go Lions!
Are you guys from Michigan?
Yes,
we're from
sir.
Ohio, but
Ohio.
About 45 minutes from Michigan.
Yeah,
from Michigan.
I've been through Ohio and Michigan too. Let me ask you a question. Do Philadelphia fans intimidate you at all?
Hell no.
And do you really understand that if they do show you hate, it's just business and nothing personal?
Yes, sir. Yeah,
we'll laugh at them.
Yeah, there you go.
We're not Cowboy fans here.
Oh, really? Well, that's good to hear, because we're not Cowboy fans here either. The city swells with history. This statue of General George Washington stands in front of the Philadelphia Art Museum. The iconic steps where people the world over come to run up in the steps of Rocky Balboa. Broad Street, going south towards the stadium complex. This can be a very interesting place even on non-game days. It has long been the custom for people to park in the center of the street. But as we go from Center City to South Philly, it becomes obvious that this is a special day. This is Sunday. This is Eagles game day. The passion of the Eagles fans does not punch a time clock. We're down here 4 hours before the game starts, and there are people outside, blocks away from the stadium, tailgating, partying, having a good time, down here to root for their birds. Blocks away from the link, people gather to celebrate their Philadelphia Eagles. They come with a passion, they come with an expectation of a victory. And they come because
The Eagles fan base is a brotherhood.
Tractor trailers are not an uncommon sight at Eagles tailgate parties. When you come down here to the area where there are many warehouses. Truck drivers, of course, 24/7, 365. They will not have the opportunity to watch this game or to hoist a few Yinglings or to give an Eagles cheer. These people may not even be Eagles fans. But one thing is for sure, Philadelphia is definitely a blue-collar town.
So, it's Sunday and game day. Who are you guys rooting for?
The Birds. Fucking Birds.
Okay, and tell me something. What is it about Philadelphia Eagles fans, the passion they have for this team?
It's just like the whole area about this morning. It don't matter who it is, who you are. You got the green on, you're going into the Wawa. You see a guy, it's like he's your brother. You say, go Birds. This guy over here, just parked next to him. He's like, it's like I've known him for 100 years.
Yeah, we all study the same thing. We see the same guys, and we love the same players. I mean, it's a family when they come down here. That's what I love about it. So we're all cheering for the same thing. We all got the same goal, and that's to win the Super Bowl, baby. Love it.
Okay, what do you think of the Dallas Cowboys?
Fuck, man.
Who do you like today?
Same team I like every Sunday. That would be your Philadelphia Eagles.
Okay, would you call yourself a passionate fan?
Some people would call me that. I call myself just a lifelong born and bred Eagles fan. I had no choice in the matter. My dad got me into it. I got my kid into it. And you're just an Eagles fan or you're not.
Okay, so what about the opponents?
What about them?
Well, I mean, when do you see the fans down here get the most rowdy?
It really depends on the situation, but if you're cool about it and you can take a ribbing from us, you're cool with us. If you stand up and try to take on 67,000 people, you're going to have a real problem.
On game day, tailgating starts early. As early as 9 o'clock. Some of these fans have been down here already for an hour. Is that passion? Is that just to have a good time? Is it just to enjoy this beautiful last Sunday of summer, this last day of summer? Is it because the Eagles are playing today? So, I guess you guys are rooting for the Lions today?
Fuck yeah, the Lions. Go Birds!
You guys have been Eagles fans for all your life, pretty much?
All my life.
Would you call yourself passionate?
There he is. Absolutely.
Okay, what about the opposition, the guys who are here rooting for the other team? What do you think of them?
Kill
them. I mean, suppose a Lions fan came up to you and said, hey, look, may the better team win. We're rooting for our team, you're rooting for your team. We respect that.
I tell them to kiss it.
Hey, guys, can I get an Eagles cheer?
E-A-G-L-E-S, Eagles!
See, there are also the ladies who are fans of the Eagles. And this group does it right. They even bring their own bar. And of course, they got Swoop up there. So tell me, who are you rooting for today?
The Birds, baby.
Okay, looks like somebody's celebrating a birthday today.
Right there.
Happy birthday. Mine's this Wednesday, by the way.
Happy birthday.
I'll be 63.
Happy birthday.
So anyway, how long have you people been Eagles fans?
Our whole lives.
So you're 40 years. 1979. So you weren't around in 1960. I was 4 years old then, and I barely have memories of it. So the Super Bowl 52 was your first World Championship with the Eagles. What were you doing that night? And you just pretty much get together to watch every game?
Every game.
All right, can I get an Eagles cheer from you?
E-A-G-L-E-S, Eagles!
The passion is dripping from these fans. Thank you. So I suppose you folks are rooting for the Eagles today, right?
Oh yeah. Vote for my cousin. Mark, let's go video here, guys.
I mean, you got the van with the canopy, you got the chairs, you got the TV, the sound system, you got a bar. You're doing it right.
Always good.
I mean, do you come down here for every game?
Yep.
Season ticket holders or just party outside?
We watch a game out here or go in. We have our choices.
Well, it's good to have your options open. Yep. But let me ask you a question. What do you think of the Dallas Cowboys?
Suck. Who?
All right, that question.
Let's hear it.
You know what? You get so tired of it. I travel for work around the country. Everyone has that star on. All it is a bunch of people have nothing going on in their life. They need to latch on to something.
You know they are, they're like Notre Dame fans.
Like Notre Dame fans. They need to latch on to something, feel part of a group, part of a crowd, be in. And you know what? When they win, their fans, their so-called fans, can never feel the way Eagle fans felt in Super Bowl 52, February 4th, 2018. Where was I? Minneapolis, Minnesota. Because we're diehard fans. Eagle fans and Cowboy fans are nothing alike. They're bandwagon, we're diehard fans.
There you go. Gonna get an Eagles cheer.
E-A-G-L-E-S, Eagles!
Okay, gentlemen, what brings you to South Philly on this lovely summer Sunday, the last day of summer?
See the birds and the beautiful weather. See them beat down the Lions, hang out, have a good time, be with friends.
How long have you been Eagles fans?
I'm 38, so 38 years.
Okay, so you don't remember 1960, but you remember 2018, I suppose.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Great year.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it? That was a great run. Why do you think Eagles fans are so passionate?
I think part of it is the city. You know, hardworking town likes to see a hardworking team, and you know, the whole blue collar mentality. People love to come out and have a good time and, you know, cheer on the team.
Can't beat Philly, man. Great people, great town, great football.
Okay, what do you think of the Dallas Cowboys?
Dallas sucks.
Sucks.
Dallas sucks.
Yeah, I hear that a lot. All right.
All right.
I did interview some Lions fans earlier today, and they said that win or lose, they're going to have a good time.
Not fun here, so they behave themselves.
I hope so.
Yeah, what should they do if somebody throws a can of beer at them?
That's what happens.
Did they catch it and drink it, maybe?
Drink it first, then throw it.
Oh, there you go.
One of the things that is special about being an Eagles fan and a brotherhood is that when you go 58 years in between championships, you lose people along the way. My dad didn't live to see the Eagles win a Super Bowl. My best friend didn't live to see the Eagles win a Super Bowl. So some of us have guilt over that, but then we also think about if there's an afterlife, they are partying up there in heaven. So it's a long tradition, and a lot of people came before us, and we have to remember those people too.
But of course, that passion is not reserved to just a few blocks of South Philly. On any given Eagles game day, at any bar in the Delaware Valley, that passion is present.
No swag. I don't know how they take that in.
No.
This is the passion. Considered the hardest hit in the history of pro football. Chuck Bednarik knocked out Frank Gifford. Forced him to sit out for a season. And now Fletcher Cox recreates this. This is the passion. This is what people think. The fact of the matter is Bednarik was celebrating because Al Wistert recovered a fumble. But people think he was lauding the hit. People thought that Gifford died. This is the type of passion. This is where the Eagles come from. So, Dave, what do you think?
Swiss, I think the Eagles are going to blow them out.
But you're not an Eagles fan, are you?
Yes, I am. Today I am.
No, today you are.
Today I am.
Because you bet on them. But what about the passion of the Eagles fans? I mean, do you think the Eagles fans are passionate?
They're crazy. They're crazy.
Crazy.
All Eagles fans are crazy.
Yeah, well, what do you think of the Dallas Cowboys?
I like them.
You do?
Especially the cheerleaders.
You like the cheerleaders, but you like the Dallas Cowboys. How did you live 95 years liking the Dallas Cowboys?
I watch them because of the cheerleaders.
Okay, so I assume you're rooting for the Lions today, right?
Absolutely not.
Okay. Are you considered a passionate Eagles fan?
Absolutely.
Okay, what's your passion for the Eagles?
My passion for the Eagles, it's a Philadelphia tradition. So.
What do you think of the Dallas Cowboys?
They suck. We have a Cowboys fan in here, and we're going to throw them out in a little while.
Okay, well, let's see what we can work with that. Do you think they'll mind if I shoot in here?
Nah, not at all.
Thank you.
All right.
So, what about the passion of Philadelphia Eagles fans?
E-A-G-L-E-S, Eagles!
That says it all.
I'm a passionate fan, yes.
For how long?
About a year and a half.
Oh, really? Where were you for Super Bowl 52?
Right here.
Okay.
And pretty much everybody here.
Yeah, I think so. This is our Eagles spot.
Okay, well, you know, why are Philadelphia fans so misunderstood?
Because we're from Philadelphia.
Would you consider this team like a more of a working class city?
Yes. Oh, without a doubt.
Now, how would you compare Eagles fans to, say, Dallas Cowboys fans?
Dallas sucks! They have a better stadium. About it.
Dallas sucks! He could just laugh at the situation.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you there, sir. Could you repeat that?
Dallas sucks! Dallas sucks! Dallas sucks!
Okay. I'm assuming by the name of this place that this is an Irish bar. Would somebody named Sullivan be welcome here?
Are you filming?
Yeah.
Because we...
Sullivan.
We serve all our Dallas fans this cup, and it literally says, fuck Dallas.
Fuck Dallas.
That's what we serve our Dallas fans, yes.
So...
Here, Jimmy.
You must be a Dallas Cowboys fan.
Oh, you don't want me on that.
Why do you root for the Eagles?
I'm a hometown girl. I've only known the Eagles all my life.
Okay, so where were you in 1960? Were you born yet?
Yes, but I was in Florida.
You were in Florida.
That was the last championship. Well, before 2017, right.
Well, what about 1960? The Dallas Cowboys didn't even exist.
That was their first year. Thank you.
Okay. Now, how did they do that year?
I can give you some Dallas statistics. I'm just chilling right
well,
now.
Well, did you ever hear that Dallas Cowboys fans? How many Dallas Cowboys fans does it take to change a light bulb? All of them.
The whole team.
All of them. They just tell you how great the old bulb was. Do you realize that the Eagles Super Bowl video is available on Blu-ray and the last Dallas Cowboys Super Bowl is available on VHS? Yingling, please. Draft.
It's awesome.
This is obviously a lively house. People here root for the Eagles. And it looks like we're going to have a little bit of fun here tonight. So it looks like Nelson Aguilar was interfered with, and the fans are happy with the call. So, is Aguilar going to have a game? Is J.J. Ortega-Whiteside going to have a game?
I hope so. It's actually a smart play.
Aguilar's going to
get beat physically. You don't want to give
so.
Up.
Yes.
Well, what you do with the ball? Do you say anything?
Now, Jake Elliott's lined up for a field goal here. With a name like that, he should be driving NASCAR, not kicking field goals, right? So, how long have you been Eagles fans? since yesterday. What is it about the Eagles that brings out passion in people, do you think?
It brings the city together. Unifies the city together for once in our lives.
Okay, so it's something that we all have in common. All right. I'm going to ask this question a lot today, but what do you people think of the Dallas Cowboys?
They suck.
Dallas who?
Dallas who?
The Dallas Cowflops.
They're irrelevant. They mean nothing. So that prick on the edge.
Any Cowboys fan is just a product of bad parenting.
Or inbreeding, maybe?
Inbreeding sounds more likely, yeah.
When you have, adoption gone bad.
When you have a couple that had the same last name before they got married.
All right, gentlemen. What is it about the Eagles that makes you passionate?
Wins.
Okay, what about the disappointment?
Shit, that's part of life.
We're used to it.
Ride high in April, shot down in May. What can you say?
There you go. How about the guy who said his last request was to have the Eagles as his pallbearer, so you've been let down one last time?
Oh, wow, really?
Right, repeat that question again?
I'm saying,
yeah, it is.
The Eagles be his pallbearer so they can let him down one more time.
Good for him.
All right. If the Dallas Cowboys were playing Al-Qaeda, who would you root for?
That is a tough question.
Hello, bitch! It's terrible!
It's getting tough after that opening field goal. The Lions just ran back a kickoff. This is going to be tough. But that's all they're getting. Oh, and there was an illegal block there that the ref missed. But, you know, it is what it is. It's how the game goes.
Yeah. Third and six coming up. And it gets crazy in the house here, people. I think he broke the plane, but it could be close. All scoring plays are reviewed. Time to game first and goal. So, Carson's going to quarterback sneak it here. Watch this.
99.
Oh, he gives it to Jordan Howard. And that's a touchdown.
G-I-G-S-D-O.
And there it is, extra point. So the Eagles take the lead. Seems like every possession is going to result in a score here. The passion, of course, isn't limited to the stadium in South Philly. I'm here at the Celtic Cross on Ashton Road in Northeast Philly. It's full of a bunch of passionate, vociferous Eagles fans, and unfortunately, one Cowboys fan. So let's see how this game turns out. So I'm now at a place where it's just a little bit more laid back, and the people don't seem to be as boisterous. But let's see if the people want to talk and see what they think. Would you call yourself a passionate Eagles fan?
I'd probably still a passionate Eagles fan. However, for anyone else.
Yeah, just like everybody else. Now, why are you an Eagles fan?
Oh, well, I'm from Philadelphia, basically born and raised. So, I mean, it's just instilled in me, honestly.
So, it's getting close to time for me to go home and watch the rest of the game in the comfort of my living room. And maybe you'll see some of the passion that I have on display there. So, now I'm home, and it's time for me to concentrate on my own passion. I get to do this solo from here on out. Right now, the Eagles are down. But it's still plenty of time in the game. And it's early.
So I accept no responsibility for my behavior from here on out. Well, I don't understand why Miles Sanders just got his helmet ripped off. I mean, it was clearly a face mask, and the official didn't call. And then Zach Ertz comes up and makes a good catch. Carson Wentz just picked up 6 yards. So Zach Ertz has just passed Pete Retzlaff for the all-time Eagles receptions list. Second and a long four here. Oh, and there was a hell of a catch by Matt Collins. So let's see what happens here. Well, this is not working out too well. So I had to put the turnover hat on. The Eagles seem to have a case of fumbleitis right now. So let's see what the defense can do here. Third and about 6. So come on, Eagles, hold them here. There's a false start. Well, he stopped him, but still. It was a full timeout. It's either a 33-yard field goal or a 4th and 2. Team is hurt. I don't get it. Fumbles? I just don't get it. Come on, miss it. Miss it! Push it to the right. There's 10 points and the Eagles kick off in the second half. They have 57 seconds to at least get 3 on the board, maybe 7.
Haven't had to do that much offensively. They had the big kickoff return for a touchdown. But you wonder, do these field goals...
I don't know. This game is starting to hurt. I mean, every game the Eagles just lay down in the first half and they come back in the second half. Do they have enough to come back in the second half?
Because of the turnovers and their own self-inflicted wounds, now how do you respond in the second half? We do know
we shall see what we shall see.
At least early this year, they've been a second half football team. Well, the Lions will get the ball to give a second half.
Well, with great passion also comes great frustration. It was a game that the Eagles could have won, probably should have won, but they lost. They had opportunities, but face it, in the final analysis, the only thing that counts is who has the most points at the end of the game. They stayed in there, but they made some bad mistakes. And I'm sure that the fans are going to be calling the talk shows tomorrow. It's something I call paralysis by analysis. It was an ugly loss. And I feel it hard. But I still feel it. And every single Eagles fan feels it right now. It's tough to lose. But there's another game Thursday. The Eagles will be playing in Green Bay. The Eagles had some of their top starters out with injuries. And some of the players in the game were playing hurt. But that's an excuse. In final analysis, they lost. And there's nothing you can say about it other than there's always next week. And that passion that the Eagles display, that the Eagles fans display, will come again next Thursday night. And we'll see what happens then. But tomorrow's just going to be a hard day throughout the Delaware Valley. Throughout Eagle Nations. For Transitions, this has been Sully, the retired Tiger Yanker. Safe and happy travels.